y'all. So welcome back to the channel. So before you get into this video, guys, make sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to hit that post notification bell. Number one, just ignore the body, y'all. But I just woke up, and I woke up to seeing that Carmen and Corey was going through something or whatever. Guys, so what I've decided to do, I'm going to insert the clips right here. And then once I insert the clips and you guys watch the clips through, I'll be back with my opinion on everything. I'm going to watch it while you guys watch it, basically. And then I'll come back, and you guys get to see my video.
This video is going to be juicy. Y'all, I'm scared to show them. Well, I'm just gonna go ahead and show y'all because it's already out there. It's not like to show y'all the messages. I'm gonna show y'all the messages from, he had texted me at 5 something this morning. I'm gonna read it to him. Oh, well, he blocked me on Instagram.
After he asked me what was
my purpose, around 5 o'clock, he said,
I don't know what you got
going on. You try the same ish every year. But I realize you forever seem like you clout chasing out my name. Just be careful what you ask for. I really don't want to go at it with you. I don't know what you have against me, but I see you haven't matured. You have 2 kids that's looking up to you.
Tough. I'm past
going back and forth with you. I've admitted my wrongs. I've moved on. So you literally finna get nothing out of this BS. And I guarantee you gonna look bad after, mark my word. Then I had people coming to me, sending me friend requests and more. I know I was wrong for sending that, but Corey, think if I ever really wanted to do this, I would have been dead. He said, I've never tried to make you look bad out here. I've tried to be nice to you and keep a mutual friendship because I just, he said, Miley, I don't bother you until you bother me. You know this, and because I'm smart. Kids, mine, that you have now. I said, kids, you know Mahalia, my daughter, is not yours. And I didn't lie. I said you had an abortion. Then I said you told me you lost the baby. I just repeated exactly what I was told when all this first happened back in 2016. I said, no, I cried to you because I was venting about our past and how you left a scar. How you lied saying you was going to wait on me. He said, Miley. I said, why you even speak on me having CJ anyway? Why you even bring that up? I said, Corey, I said, look, I do love you a lot, but just stop lying on me. And I'm finna block that boy from Birmingham because something mentally wrong with him. He said, because people was on my live bringing all that stuff up. I'm going to say this for both ends of this situation. Delete all your little lies. I'm going to delete all my little posts. I'm going to tell dude to delete his stuff and don't mention you again. I'm not going to speak on you no more, and you do the same. Because this is lame, and you know I've matured. I ain't on this type of time no more. I said, hold on then. You said I don't know who my baby dad is. I said, you really wrong. Corey, we can't delete none of this no more. It's already out thanks to your mop head blank friend.
He said, I didn't say that.
He's talking about the baby dad situation. I said, plenty of people got your life and mine, and with you and the little boy. It's on Instagram, too. He said, man, just delete it. F them. I said, that boy sent all that stuff to his friends. You feel me? For backup. He said, they live for stuff like this. I'm not stunning them. I said, Corey, go to sleep. He said, you got it. I'm deleting my stuff. You ain't got to worry about me speaking on you. Just move on. Wish you the best. We both have kids looking up to us. Stop entertaining this social because they laughing, they not laughing with you, they laughing at us. I'm gonna talk about Florida first. I'm gonna go to
me and Carmen messages about me
and Corey. Then I'm gonna go to me and Corey messages. And she said, yeah, you confuse me with crying emojis. I said, after she called me, I said, what's up? I missed her call, I didn't answer. She said, I just don't like when people playing games with me or lying to me. I said, okay, I can understand that, but tell Corey. She said, yeah, but you hit him up first, though. And I already asked him what it's about, and he said, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm going to tell you the same thing, baby. Someone basically complaining about him or what he do, etc., etc., then want to link with him, I'm confused. Never mind, I see you don't see the bigger picture. That's what she said.
I said, baby,
you don't. You don't see the bigger picture. I'm just trying to have fun. He said, man, you can't be serious.
I said, I'm dead
for real. Like, he said, where you at, man? I said, I'm at the condo. He said, what condo? I told him where we was at. He said, I just left from that way. He said, "Who condo you at? Who condo y'all at?" I said, "We at my cousin's, because we had booked the Airbnb."
I said, "They straight."
Because they already know. He said, "Mm-hmm, sending on." He said, "Who all there?" I said, "Mostly family, but we got you. Everybody know that you my ex." He said, "Bruh," with a laughing emoji. I said, "Man, come on." He said, "All right, man, finna just stop by now." I said, "Okay, call me when you outside." He said, "You gonna hit me." Y'all know how his speakers is in his truck. I said, "Don't do all these," because it was other folks there too. I didn't want too much attention. Like, I ain't like all these. He said, "Okay, come out." He called me. He said, "That was me that just called." I said, "I know." He said, "Text that number. I don't want to rush you, but you know what you got to do." He said, "You know what you gonna do?" Asking me to come back with him back to Union Springs. He said, "Therefore, I can get you now before going to get gas on the way out to Union Springs." I said, "Y'all coming back tomorrow, because we having fun." In Florida, we was having fun, but he had paid me just to chill with him and whatnot. Okay, and about the meetups, since he said he never met with me, he never cheated on Carmen with me, he
didn't
see me in 2 years, so I'm gonna show some more proof. These are text messages.
When we met at the park,
he said, "Come on." I said, "Bet, I'm on the way." He said, "How far?" I lied and said, 20 minutes, because you came out trying to surprise him and whatnot. He said, "God damn, this you?" He said, "I love you a lot, man." I said, "I love you too. I'm not gonna show y'all this message or that message. It's too explicit." Okay, that's the
floor part situation. After that, I'm finna show y'all the messages
when we will meet up in
Springs.
Okay, September the 4th.
You ready? I'm down the road.
"What you doing, lady?" I said, "I gotta work. I'm finna drop them off." He asked me how long it was gonna take.
He dropped the location
to where he was at.
Because he was supposed to come pick
me up from my house, but he was drawing too much attention in Montgomery. So he had to go back to
Union Springs. I said, "I don't
even need the GPS. I remember everything, because
I ain't gonna talk about it." He said, "Cap," he said, "better
use that GPS, because he's saying
it was a new house and whatnot."
I said, "Oh God." He said, "How far are you?" I told him how far I was. Keep in mind, it was September the 4th.
We still texting.
And then we had seen each other
again, but he had to go pick up
Carmen, and they had to go back to Houston.
He came to see me or whatnot before he had came to go get her. He said, "I'm heading out now.
She finna
to be with me. You be safe. I enjoyed you.
I'm here if you need me."
You didn't go ahead and come on, because you supposed to be came yesterday.
Man, I was told y'all would call, but shit, I ain't have a fucking car.
How you ain't had no car and you got all them fucking cars?
I didn't want to drive. I wanted to drive my car.
Well, you need to do better.
Thanks.
And then you lied to him, so I'm going to fix your phone, because that shit trash. You sitting talking about my phone.
I'm going to tell my mom to cash up the money ASAP.
Okay, thank you, because I need to.
My fucking dog, and then I'm going to call your ass. By Friday, your shit ain't peace. I'm going to go start the fucking table.
Look, you know I ain't with that shit now. Stop playing with me.
I'm just saying.
Stop playing with me.
I'm going to help you to walk
up
and tone
and
shit.
Oh, I don't need that, baby. I can do that myself.
I know.
You offered it. You offered it. So.
You said I gave my father.
Well, your son here, you can come get him.
Name change something.
I mean, sit up.
You
got to
change something. You don't need it.
So, what you finna do? You finna go ahead and drop the car and then what?
I'm gonna be here for a minute. Fuck with that man.
What you finna get?
Well, I'll correct that shit real quick.
We need to do a replay of your birthday night. That shit was lit.
I bought the shit out of you on my birthday.
And then look. And then you tell some. Whew. That was good.
My other business that pay you.
I got me haircut myself.
You look fine back there.
I guess.
What's that up? I did my eyebrow look.
God damn. Get a microphone.
I'm scared.
It said on her.
Oh my god, my phone fell.
She got that baby.
Yeah. Splash.
Just to tell y'all what I think about the video, guys. Like I said, ignore the money, guys, because I kind of just woke up to this and decided that I wanted to like watch it and react to it or whatever. But anyway, guys, before I get into how I feel about it, make sure you guys leave a comment down below and tell me what you guys think, and I will be responding to everybody's comment, guys. But anywho, I just feel like, for one, she knows he's married, so she's making herself look dumb. Two, how can you say Carmen needs to respect herself? You have to respect yourself as well. You know this is a married man, and you're still doing what you're doing. And it's like, you're trying to expose her, but you're exposing the person that you truly are while you're doing that. Second of all, her timestamps are off. I don't know if you guys noticed, but I'm going to insert one screenshot here, one screenshot here. These two things were supposed to be from the same day, but the dates on them were two different things. And how was it she went from texting one of his Facebook messengers to all of a sudden another Facebook messenger all the way to text message? Her timestamps and her receipts, they don't even seem legit. Plus, this is an old situation. This is a 2016 to 2018 situation that she's trying to bring up in 2020. Let's all remember that, for one, Corey hasn't had that charge for, what, a year and a half now? Second of all, let's remember that he admitted to messing around while Carmen was pregnant because they had already broken up. So how is it now she's trying to bring up the fact she's trying to say they was pregnant at the same time, supposedly? But at this time, Corey's in Houston and he wasn't going home like that, and you stay all the way in what, Alabama? It's just like the timestamps and the information she's giving isn't making sense, because she's trying to keep an old situation relevant, in my opinion. But guys, that's just my opinion, you know, her worth, and she finally moves on from this situation, and she lets them just continue on their life however they choose. So guys, that's all I really got to say about the situation. To me, it was a whole bunch of BS. And I hope everybody just doesn't just jump to a conclusion and believe everything that they see on social media. But guys, without further ado, that is going to be the end of today's video. So I'll catch you guys in tomorrow's video, because I'm about to go ahead and get ready for my day. So,
just let me go if that's what it is. These niggas don't love no one but themselves. I can't deny all the feelings.